When we talk about inflow control technology, this is always associated with pressure drop. And when we have pressure drop or choke mechanism downhole, to understand how much we choke is essential. And one technique the industry normally use is a reservoir model to simulate inflow control technology in downhole condition. Basically, the objective is just to optimize the production and get the best out of the well and have a better recovery. So in the reservoir model, the first element that very important is the PVT, or which is the fluid property. We have to know what is the viscosity and density of oil, water and gas, because most inflow control either is density sensitive or viscosity sensitive. So fluid property is one thing. Second is the ability for the well to flow, which is normally measured by permeability. So in theory, if you have high permeability, basically more flow will come towards that high permeability zone compared to low permeability zone. Some reservoir have higher permeability, some have low permeability, and some have mix of high and low. And then the third one is saturation. This is the most important out of three, because this is the unknown parameter in most reservoir model. Like permeability, we will able to measure it when we drill. PVT, we are able to measure it when we drill. But saturation, we are able to measure it only on day one. And most oil and gas well have been drilled for 10 to 20 years life. When we drill the well, most of the time we come across the high oil saturation zone, which is represented by this green color. Basically, along the well will be oil. So it is easy. And then after some time, the water will break through, which is represented by the blue color. And then after some time again, the gas can break through, which is represented by the red color. And the question is, when the gas and water will break through and where? And then we try to predict that as best we can. However, we maybe miss, because that will depend on where the oil water contact is and where the gas water contact is. And again, depend on permeability. If we have sandstone reservoir, the permeability varies from 50 millidarcy and then can go as high as 2,000-3,000 millidarcy depending on the sand quality. If we have a high permeability, let's say in the heel, and low permeability in the toe, then if we don't have any inflow control technology, in the high permeability, this is where most breakthrough will come earlier compared to the low permeability area. And the second type of common reservoir we see is the carbonate reservoir. The permeability is very, very low. They call it metric permeability. It sometimes will be around 1 millidarcy to 5 millidarcy, which is quite difficult to flow, and most flow is depending on fracture. The fracture can be almost like a very, very high short interval high permeability. So most of the flow is coming from the fracture. If let's say water or gas coming through the fracture, then we need to do something to just stop the flow from this zone. So, if we are using typical or traditional technology, which is just maybe open hole or screen only, we have to run down this well with PLT, which is one of the logging technique, to find out where the gas is and where the water is. And ideally, we straddle. Straddle means we try to isolate that zone. However, that takes time and money to do it and find out which zone. And then having AICV in the well, in the day one, we don't really need to know this saturation. Regardless of where the water coming and where the gas coming, the autonomous valve can detect what is the fluid type and close autonomously. What this means is, with AICV, or autonomous control valve technology, we don't need any more PLT. So that's one thing. Second thing, if we have different permeability area, high in the heel and low in the toe, the AICV can balance the influx from heel to toe and delay the breakthrough of water and delay the breakthrough of gas. And once it's breakthrough, we will close that section or choke that section depending on what's the production strategy. And the best thing about it, if let's say after a few years, gas back to the gas cap and oil coming back, the AICV can always open back this section and not leave any oil behind. So to design that, this is where we use a pressure chart to understand how much pressure actually the AICV need to choke the section that have breakthrough. What we have here, this blue line is reservoir pressure. The red line is bottom hole pressure. And this purple line is the AICV pressure drop. And in the area that we have high oil saturation, the AICV will provide a low pressure drop, which is represented by this purple pressure. And that means the reservoir drawdown is very high. What that means is, basically the AICV is fully open and most of the flow is coming from this zone. In the zone that we have gas breakthrough, the AICV will apply high pressure drop. That means we are closing the main flow. Then the reservoir drawdown will become very, very small, which what that means is we don't take flow from this section. This is how AICV regulate the oil, water and gas. And this will be balanced throughout the life of the well.